I'm going to introduce Tohoku Medical Megabank organization, and three of the dear scientists will present the details. So I just give next 30 minutes. I'll introduce the Megabank. Okay. Thank you. By the way, this is the Cavendish James Watson's Watson Crick. Great. Okay, so again, let me introduce the MM progress of the Tohoku Medical Megabank. Before introducing the Tohoku Medical Megabank, let me tell you a little bit of my personal experience. So, all we know, the March 11th, we got the big earthquake and tsunami. But the slightly before the earthquake, I was in the Washington D.C. and the Society of Toxicology gave me a prize about the finding of some my scientific achievements. So I went there, Washington D.C. and gave a award seminar from the direct flight and Haneda Tokyo Airport, the 5 a.m. in the morning. Then I got another invitation to give a seminar in Kyoto around here. So the lunch seminar, and I took a train from Kyoto to Tokyo back. Then the March 11, 2:46 p.m. We got the really big earthquake. And it was enormous. Fortunately, my train moves slowly, and the 10 o'clock, at 10 p.m. In the night, arrived to Tokyo Station, and there is a Tokyo office of Tohoku University nearby the Tokyo Station. So at that moment, I was a vice president of the university. So, quite a serious and dedicated vice president. So I went there to take care of the Tohoku University people, if they say Tohoku University people. Then I found that quite a lot of our university people, refugee, stayed in there. But I'm the youngest and the most lower grade vice president, and I'm the only one of the managing board of the university to appear, showed up here. So I'm proud of that. The president is not here, so I'm okay. All right. Now, so the night I stayed in Tokyo, the Sendai was like this, the big tsunami, and our people can't stay in the real building. So went to the gym and stayed there. And please see, no futon or no blanket. And the outside is snowy. So I just got a phone call in the midnight and asked them, how are you alive? Still alive? What's going on? Then they said, hey, vice president, Dean, it's very cold outside, it's snowy. Very cold, snowy. So I got a hint, and my friend, the Professor Miyata, has a good friend of this company, Koyama Corporation. And this is one of the biggest rental company of the futon and blanket to the hospital. So Professor Miyata and I made a phone call to this company and asked them to let us as many as possible futons and blankets, and then collected 600 sets of futons and 2,000 blankets in Tokyo. Then I was so brave at that moment. I asked them to rent also a truck, a lorry, and I borrowed the lorry and drove this one from Tokyo to Sendai. Probably you've traveled to Tokyo to Sendai by airplane. At that moment, no planes. Our airport was destroyed like this way, and no trains, so this is the only way. And highway is actually not the highway because of bumps and the road was destroyed, so very slow drive from Tokyo to here. Anyway, at that moment, finally I brought the futon and the blanket. I was just like a movie star. Everybody says, wow. Anyway, I was the first came back to the center here. And finally, we learned the tsunami attacked wide area of this region. And you may hear the Fukushima. In the Fukushima, the atomic nuclear plant was destroyed. And in our prefecture, Miyagi region, more than 10,000 people lost. And almost 20,000 people die in this area. So, well, we need to think about something, and especially as a medical school professor, we're really curious about how hospitals doing, and all big big hospitals are gone, and the doctors are also suffered. And actually, we lost the solution. How can I do? And this is the big hospital in the Ishinomaki city nearby. And quite a lot of people came to this hospital. So our university sent the 1,500 doctors to this area in the 2 months period. But still, probably that's not enough. But the important question is, what can I do? What shall we do as a medical scientist? So we discussed this and in the faculty's meeting here. We discussed this, and the conclusion was like this: creative regeneration. A core project is required to revitalize the Tohoku area, and we need the attractive and thriving center of the innovation. And this must be the core engine of the regeneration. So we decided to do something. And what is the good project as an engine? That's the next issue. So, and this one, I got this slide from Professor Kuriyama, and he studied the tsunami disaster in the Sumatra, Indonesia, 2004. And this was also a big tsunami. And after the tsunami, the post-traumatic experience syndrome, or those are mental diseases or long-term cardiovascular diseases. Those are the common happenings after the big disaster. So we need to think about the way to treat the Tohoku people free or mild these diseases and symptoms. So to fight against the increasing disease, we need the health status monitoring and social support, medical support for the suffering. And another one is personalized prevention or medicine for these people. So this is our goal. And to do that real thinking practice. The support of the residents in the suffered area is one big issue. And those suffered area from the beginning, the not so many doctors, in a way, quite a small number of doctors are doing the countryside rural medicine. And young doctors tend not to go to that region. So we are really thinking to provide a clue for this program. And finally, leads to the idea of large scale genome cohort and integrated biobank. And personalized healthcare will be a good project for the regeneration. And finally, maybe the Tohoku Medical Megabank organization. And after listening to Mark's talk, we really feel jealous because in Japan, we don't have a good numbering system, not the numbering system of the patients or the healthy people. And also, the electronic chart system is not well developed. So the chasing, following up the patient is also difficult. So we need to work on this also. So finally, the February 2012, almost 1 year after the earthquake, we organized Tohoku Medical Megabank organization. And the logo mark of this is ToMMo. ToMMo means friends in Japanese. So we will be the friends of the suffering people. And one immediate thing we need to work on is to support the suffered hospitals. And for that purpose, Tohoku University sent the young doctors to the community hospitals. And these doctors stay 4 months in the community hospitals. Then they turn to our university and work on their own research or the training. And next person will go. So 3 person makes a team and support 1 position in the local hospital. This system works very well, and they supported those suburban hospitals. And the hospitals gradually are recovering, and new hospitals is now under construction and are getting better. Now, I want to talk about what is the most advanced medicine. So we really want to challenge the advanced medicine and make the engine. And then what we saw is the personalized medicine and the personalized healthcare. And personalized medicine, in this case, patient will be treated just like the Max MS case. The patient analyze the genome analysis of the patient will help the individual treatment, individualized treatment. We usually call this one as personalized medicine. On the other hand, personalized healthcare, this is based on the health examination and the genetic and environmental factors analysis. We will risk assess the risk and preventive medicine. So we usually call this one personalized medicine. And for the purpose of the personalized medicine, we need to develop the basic science, especially the cohort study and biobank. These are the key issues to establish the personalized healthcare. And for the personalized healthcare, what is the important diseases. We are thinking the common diseases better diagnosis or better treatment of the common diseases, which is the usually happens by the interplay of the genetic and environmental factors. And for the treatment of these common diseases, genome cohort and biobank is necessary and powerful. And especially the genome analysis for complex with the prospective topo is important to solve this issue. So we decided to work on the genome cohort. And what type of the cohort we are organizing operating in ToMMo. And we are operating two types of the cohort. One is the resident cohort. Both are prospective cohort. And the resident cohort, 80,000 people are collected from the suburb area. And the another one is a three generation cohort. And we're going to recruit 70,000 resident for the three generation cohort. And in this case, we first recruit pregnant mom, then pregnant mom and baby, and husband, grandpa, grandma, the generation. So, and also siblings. Those three are generation studies. And the Mark just pointed out, twins analysis is very powerful. And we also, I fully agree with that. And those three generation cohort analysis will be very powerful to make the linkage between the gene variation and the disease interplay. So then our target genes, and this is a prospective cohort. So usually we can't have the good hypothesis. The disease, if somebody now healthy person, if we follow long time, they will develop some kind of diseases. But so whatever disease comes, we need to study that disease. So this is a no hypothesis cohort study. But we can tell from the statistics these cancers or cardiovascular diseases or diabetes, mental diseases, those will appear. And as I showed you in this Matra case, those stress will increase the mental diseases or cardiovascular diseases. So our target genes are cardiovascular disease, diabetes, depression, PTSD. And also we are doing the three generation cohort. So childhood disease like atopic dermatitis or bronchial asthma or autism, those are also our target disease. And to do this, the cohort study, we put the seven regional centers in this area. And Japan is a tiny country, but still it's large. So we put the seven regional centers and recruit the participants by using these regional centers. And in these regional centers, we do a quite precise biochemical and physiological examinations, including the mental magnetic resonance imaging, MRI. And we started this recruit last year, May 20th last year. So it's almost 1.5 years now. And we are collected the regional cohort more than 40K, and the three generation cohort more than 11,000. So right now we've finished probably today. This is a little bit before. So probably today we probably finished 60,000 people recruited in 1.5 years. So the prospective cohort from the beginning, it's difficult because the participants are healthy people, not so strong motivations to join. And 1.5 years, 60 million, I feel like this is a Guinness Book record. And all right. Now, how can we establish the personalized medicine healthcare? And I explained you the diseases like Mendelian inheritance disease, disease solely determined by genetic factors, the analysis has been done almost now. So our target is the disease caused by the gene and the environmental interactions. So this type of the disease is our target, and mostly those are lifestyle related common diseases. And one important hypothesis for the analysis of this disease are published by Manrio. She insists like this way. The Mendelian type disease, the quite rare, but the effect size is very big. So one point mutation makes the disease. But GBAS analysis are currently ongoing. GBAS analysis, it's quite common, but the effect size is low. So we can find the good relation of the mutations or variations to the disease. And the important target, our target is here. So common disease, common variant hypothesis, we don't take that hypothesis. We take the rare variant, low frequency, rare variant variation, and the common disease, rare variant common disease hypothesis. And for this purpose, we need to sequence our gene precisely. And for that purpose, we decided to work on the whole genome sequencing. And for the whole genome sequencing, we set up the sequencing facility. And we put quite a lot of effort to do the efficient whole genome sequencing and develop our own quality controls, standard operation SOP, and such and such. And finally, we finished the 10,070 full genome sequence from the cohort participants. And the full genome sequence is more than 1,000 is first in Japan, of course. And this one is a single laboratory, single protocol, single facility sequencing with high coverage. While the international consortium sequence is a multiple laboratory, multiple protocol, multiple facility, and low coverage. So it's a quite different. And we've identified 12 million SNPs, and this SNP story will be explained, introduced by the next speakers. So I will skip. But anyway, part of this snippet information is open now from our ToMMo homepage and also National Database Center in Japan. And this one, we collected the cohort people, 1,070 people for genome analysis and the sequence variation and the sequence with database. And this one we call the Integrated Japanese Gene Variation Database, JVD, JVD. And this one is a good data to understand how the Japanese genome is organized, and also a good reference for the clinical sequence will be a very good control reference for the whole genome sequence. But also, we are going to make the Japonic RNA. Join us, the last speaker of today will introduce our strategy to make the Japonic RNA, the ethnic specific RNA, which is powerful tools, powerful means for monitoring Japanese people. So ours is a cohort sample. We have a sample, the health record, or the disease record, and the database, and making this unified and integrated database, this will be, of course, a good tools to develop new drugs, as Mark introduced in this talk. And I'm thinking probably the genomic DNA analyzed and returned by the specialist in a medical practice is important. The direct to consumer business is not important. Well, direct to consumers, direct to consumer business will not help the health strategy. I clearly think this should be done in the National Health Service. National Health Service, in the framework of the National Health Service, and all the pilot study of this is very important. Now, the Naoko Minegishi, this afternoon will present how our biobank is organized. But I'm sure the biobank is beneficial for the society, and especially large size biobank is good for quality control and the efficient use of the resources. And while we are collecting the samples, but from last year, we started the preliminary distribution of the samples. But let me tell you a little bit about this. Our bank, we are aimed to construct the complex integrated biobank. In this case, complex integrated means we're going to analyze the sample by ourselves, and we'll distribute the samples and the information. So save the use of the samples as small as possible. First, we're going to do the analysis. Everybody's interesting analysis we're going to do. And we will distribute the information first. Then the crucial part, we'll distribute the samples. That's the idea, integrated biobank idea. And to do this, we need the new type of the specialist, and like the clinical geneticists, genetic doctors, and GMRC, or those people. And in Japan, there is a Japanese Society of Human Genetics certifies the 436 GMRC in this nation, and more than 200 is in this organization, so we are winning here. So our new building is done, biobank, supercomputer, and the regional center for the health examination. And we've collected almost 60K participants already. And first we've started this one. Almost 10 or 12 people are working on this, but now more than 440 people working in this project, and we really hoping to finish this project. We really want to collect 150 participants. Okay, thank you very much, and I'm happy to ask you answer your questions.